So then, I think, what are the next ones? Swati, right? Yeah, go ahead.
Swati for wind god, Swati is for respiration, Swati is for pranayamas and all is very good. That you can activate Swati because it's a wind. You're channeling the wind in and out of the body. That's what Swati is. And something related to dispersing after wind is again the dispersion energy is there in Swati Nakshatra. So do some pranayamas at least. That's a good remedy for Swati. And that is also a good remedy if you have any planets or such, if you want to really activate Swati Nakshatra.
Yeah. Swati, I would say one simple remedy is to grow a plant from the seed stage. So that seed you have to put, but then it will become a plant. And when it's flowering, you have to give different kind of nutrients, that kind of thing. So you'll develop patience with Swati. Pranayama is excellent for Swati. Keeping a picture of Saraswati is excellent for Swati.
Okay.
Swati, the easiest thing is to get another mentor, like Hanuman, phone Ram, find a simple mentor with whom you can talk so that you're not losing your energy interactions. It's a very simple thing. Maybe your brother, maybe your elder brother, your father, elder sibling, someone like that, someone whom you would consider elder, they're actually good for Swati. They'll give you some kind of push for them because Swati might serve too many directions. What about Vishaka, Aditya?
Vishaka is again related to tiger, and because animal symbol is tiger, and Vishaka is again the symbol is opposite branches. So maybe you may have two options. So focusing, that's another one of the important thing of Vishaka, focusing and attention and all those things. It's very important for Vishaka Nakshatra. And what else comes in my mind? I don't know right now. Indra Agni is the planetary god
Right.
associated with that. So again. Indra Agni, Indra plus Agni, and so precision and all those things is also very important for Vishaka, I think. The meticulous
Okay.
and we pay attention to details. Some of the themes which I seen with Vishaka Nakshatra people.
Vishaka, I would say, being willing to do two things at the same time, that is fine. Indra side of you have an Agni side of other side, and that's completely fine for them to do two things, to have two different jobs, two different things, a hobby and being in an alternative career. Other thing with Vishaka, we talked in, is like to have a pillar inside your home or to go to places where there are pillars, like a bridge or something. So very simple thing. Other thing with Vishaka is again, simply fire rituals, fire again, Indra Agni. So lighting a fire, lighting candles, like how in the group homas, temples. So even bonfires, you see that also happening here. Vishaka.
Putting the decorating the archway, in the home they put
Yeah,
the
yeah.
door.
Make your doorway into an archway instead. That's a simple thing. People do that, right? With their homes and buy decorative things
I will
and
just come. I need to get my charger. You can go ahead with Anuradha.
yeah. Yeah, so I'll begin with Anuradha. Anuradha is basically Mitra, so god of friendship. Getting picture of Radha Krishna is a simple thing with Anuradha. I'd also say with Anuradha, lotus flower is a great thing. So, lotus flower to a god is very Anuradha thing. Anuradha, what any suggestion, Babaji, for Anuradha?
Anuradha, I have seen that these people they want to help others. So, like we can also put photo of a handshake. We can do that. I've seen the people they net and I know people who have Anuradha very strong. You go to their home, and I have seen this. They don't know anything about astrology. They don't have any idea, but that's still there will always be photo about love or romance or something like this. It has to be there, and the moment it is there, I know that person has planets, or at least the Lagna in Anuradha. That has to be there. So, but it again depends, as we discussed earlier, which aspect of that we want to activate. So, if it is marriage, maybe we can keep something like that, or maybe if it is
Right.
we want a business partnership, we can keep something else related to that. So.
Yeah, with Anuradha, yeah,
Devotion.
that for sure. Yeah, go ahead, Aditya.
No, I will say devotion. Anuradha devotion.
Okay, yeah.
Selfless activities can be done.
Yeah.
Devotion, Radha, and all those. So that's what comes to my mind. Anuradha, Radha, deep selfless love or
Yeah.
devotion.
Yeah.
Bhakti,
Anuradha,
presence, basically. I
I would
think
say.
one of my friend is strong, Anuradha. Oh, he's into all the time into bhajans and all those things.
Yeah. Bhajan, yeah.
And
Bhajan is
one thing
exactly, yeah. I would say with Anuradha,
we
go ahead.
forgot to discuss last time we discussed that particular scriptures, like for Punarvasu, we can discuss Ramayan. And for Uttar Falguni, because it's related to Arjun, we can discuss the Gita or Mahabharata. No?
Yeah.
We can discuss. Yeah. And for
Radha, you can say Rumi, all that kind of poetry, find it helpful. Or Radha Krishna poetry, or Kirtans, or, you know, that poetry.
And for Pushya, they can read the Srimad Bhagavatam, because it is written by Brihaspati, and Bhagavatam was spoken by Vyasdev at its highest level of maturity. So that, like, so that's where Jupiter gets exalted. So then they can read Srimad Bhagavatam.
Yeah, for I would say Durga Saptashti for Mula also. Mula is possible, Durga Saptashti, old goddess kind of thing. Or, you know, I would even say chanting Mula mantras for Mula, Mula Nakshatra. Mula mantras, Bij mantras, you know. I would say one thing I'm curious about is, so yeah, one thing I want to add was, some nakshatras, they have Aditya, some certain Adityas are the gods, nakshatras have certain Rudras are the gods. So Aditya, certain chant mantras for Adityas in general, like Om Mitraya Nama, Om Nama, that kind of thing. That is also very helpful for, helping out the Adityas in your chart, or Aditya role nakshatras. That's one suggestion I have for Mitra, because Mitra is an actual god whom you can worship, you know. So that's one suggestion I want to emphasize for Andhrada, because Mitra is an actual sun god. Like Varna Mitra, they say, right? So, with Andhrada, I'll just say that look into the corresponding, identified person in your life. So that's a simple thing I would say.
You can make in Andhrada, no?
Friendship. Right. Yeah. What about Jeshta?
Jeshta is what basically related to Indra. So basically rulership and all those things.
Jeshta can be.
Fights, competition, wars. Now when I say fights, it's all about competitiveness and all. So
with Jeshta, I would say definitely you have to watch out for the downsides of, read the story of Indra. That's what I would say for Jeshta for sure. And don't make his mistakes. The easiest thing is that. Second thing I would say is also, read about Jeshta Devi. You speak about, like, if you keep and if you wear unclean clothes, Jeshta Devi comes and takes away your wealth. Like, kind of say, they say even if you eat curd in the night, Jeshta Devi comes and eats, takes away your wealth, you know, supposedly. Yeah, they say that. So Devi, look into Jeshta Devi.
Because they will say eat curd during the daytime, but eat curd is basically coolness effect, and if you night is cold, and if you get cold you may get sick. If you get sick you go to doctor. If you go to doctor they take away your money. So that's why money goes up. So maybe that can be a thing.
Yeah. Just a big theme of jealousy. Indra was jealous about many things, so just not to be that. Just was jealous of Rohini also. So yeah, it's a big thing I would say. What about
Mula Nakshatra, going to the roots basically. So understanding from going to the deep research, controlling your anger issues. One of the major themes.
Anger.
And Mula, they can also do the grass cutting and such stuff. You know, have you seen people doing that?
Yes. Grass cutting, yes. Very good for Mula. Yeah.
Because what is Mula? Mula is picking up, correct? Something related to...
And Mula people, I have seen, they I don't know, in Guwahati this is visible, but in metros maybe it's difficult, or maybe in abroad outside India it's possible, that there are big grasses now in the lawns of some big people, you know, and they are very soft to walk, you know.
Yeah.
So Mula people I have seen, they like to walk in that barefoot, you know, so. Not the normal grass, you know, which is like bit big, and when you put your leg, you know, go inside, very nice.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I have seen that they like this.
Interesting. Mula, I would say, because Mula brings about some kind of destruction. Be careful about money you lent to someone else. You won't get it back sometimes. So be careful of that. Mula, again, I would say go to very old temples, very super old temple. That is great Mula remedy. Go to any old pilgrimage places, natural wonders, things like that. Mula also feeding dogs, you know, because Ketu. That's the other thing I would say with Mula. Take care of a dog, help out a dog, things like that. Yeah. So what about Purvashada?
Purvashada strategies, making plans. At least making plans. for the making new resolutions, I will say. Yeah, I think Urvashada is connected with those, all those qualities.
And of course,
writing.
Yeah.
Writing.
What? Writing. Yes, writing. Likita Jabba, right? Yeah. It's a Purvashada.
Confusion here. They say Bhishma Pitama is related to Purvashada. They say, and they say he's also related to Dhanishta. So, which one exactly is it?
I would say Bhishma Pitama because he's one of the Vasus, right? But Purvashada, yeah. I'm not sure.
Because Purvashada has element of celibacy in that, and he took a vow of celibacy. Because of that, they say this, I guess.
Okay, interesting. I wasn't aware about that. Could be possible. But yeah, Dhanishta because of Vasu, so mythologically that's there. They say like Mula is also connected with Hanuman, but Hanuman is also connected with Swati because he's the Vayu Putra. So Vayu's essence is also there. So multiple things can be there, possibly.
Yeah, Purvashada,
I would say. Yeah,
Purvashada, they say that when Indra was, you know, when he finally was doing the Pashyatap for Indrasura and for killing Vishwarup, so then he was purifying. So that they say that is the nakshatra where that happened. So that is why they say that during Purvashada, or if you have any planet, then your purity can be tested or your purity can be checked. Now, like suppose you have Venus in Purvashada, then your spouse might ask you that, you know, are you pure, or you know, sometimes these kind of questions can come out. That's what I have seen sometimes.
That makes sense. The Purvashada, I would say, purifying on that act, you can pour water, pour your sins over Shivling. That'll be the easiest thing. So that Shiva will destroy impurities. Purvashada also seen like water.
Now, Saturn is also there, transiting in Purvashada. Exactly, yeah. Whole year, Saturn Ketu will be dancing, you know, in Purvashada.
Yeah, so pour water, tooling, easy remedy for Saturn. Saturn is, you know, God is, she do that. Ketu is like, so do something, pour water for Ganesh or something, you know. Purvashada, definitely waters, I would say. Before you drink any water, chant some mantra into the water and then drink that water. It's a very simple thing. That's a simple solution. I've seen that. Purvashada, one last thing I would say is like read the Mahabharata. There's also a lot of strategies and stuff in Mahabharata also. Hasta is also Mahabharata. Purvashada is Mahabharata, I would say. What about Uttarashada, Aditya?
Uttarashada is again connected with writing, but final victory. So again, something competitive themes are coming there, I see.
Yeah.
And what are the devas? It's like Vishwa devas are connected. Nature, basically. Respect elements of nature. Go in nature, maybe. Nature walk.
Uttarashada, I would say spiritual practice will be there. Not to be egoistic about your spiritual practice. The people who get egoistic, right? I went to that temple, all that. Uttarashada. Second thing I would say with Uttarashada is like you know, something with elephant, buying elephant things. It's a very simple thing, I would say. With Uttarashada and Purvashada, buying elephants. Uttarashada also mongoose. So, you know, there is also some country with Kubera, I think. You know, some kind of Kubera thing. So, that's also the... So, look into Kubera mantras or whatever. Because of mongoose connection there, yeah. Yeah, participate competitions. Simply participate competitions to participate, go to back. You know. So Purvashada kind of thing, or Uttarashada, What about Shravana?
Shravana is here, of course, hearing thing, three steps, miles, and then respecting gurus can be a theme to Shravana.
Yeah.
Hearing Vaman story, man, from Bhagavata.
Vaman, Bhagavatam. Vaman Purana, whatever, you know, Vaman chapter, or yeah. I would say like with the Shravana, simple theme is like, go around the temple three times. It's a Vamana thing. Three things. Do anything three times. Walk a lot with Shravana. That's also three steps. Walking is easier remedy. Listening to your gurus or listening to satsangs is also Purvashada remedy.
Some land connection. Land, property, home.
Yeah. Donating land, yeah. Donating land.
Vamana has three steps of land, correct?
Yeah. Donate land if you can.
And in Shravana, I have seen sometimes that you might be forced to downgrade yourself. Like Bali Maharaj wanted to be in the heavens, but then he had gone to Sutala. But in Srimad Bhagavatam, it is mentioned that Sutala is actually more opulent than Swarga than Amaravati.
Yeah.
And Vamandev is
Yeah.
the personal doorkeeper of Bali Maharaj there. So
Okay.
that this is what I have seen, that sometimes when Shravan Nakshatra is there, I have seen people that they are forced to leave something which they think will make their life worse, which is completely opposite of what they wanted. But actually later on they will realize maybe that, okay, this happened, this was actually for my good. This was actually where I should have been in the first place, because Indra, the heavens are supposed to be ruled by the devatas, because they have done that pious activity, that number of Ashwamedha yagyas and those rituals to go. So it is not that Indra and other devatas are just, you know, occupying heaven and the demons are like,
right.
no, we will sit there. So
right.
It's like, know your place, you know, that quote I would use for Shravan, you know where you belong and be happy there. And that's good for you, actually. So they may get rejection sometimes, you know, if they want to go here, there. And regarding that, I have also seen people taking homes and settling down.
Oh, okay. People taking homes and settling down? Like what?
No, like we were discussing about the Tribhagi Dasha system, that in Moon Dasha, Shravan will get active. So by that,
okay.
I have seen whenever Shravan gets active, and the funny thing is, even if the Antar Dashas during that part has no link with the fourth house, even then they purchase property, I have seen.
Interesting.
Yeah, or something to do with family, or the family tells them that stay here, don't go outside, stay here, you should be here,
okay.
Don't go there. And then somehow they have this big aim that I want to go there, but then they are forced to stay here, or they decide, or something like this I have seen with family and...
Very interesting. Something to do with property or family or family.
Yeah, property is very integral, I guess, because that whole thing was related to three steps only. Na? So property has to be.
Talking about property, I'm seeing one guy here shifting all his things. He's leaving his home. He's going somewhere. I don't know. He's getting all the things. Some shifting is happening. You see from. Yeah, he's, some three bags are coming. Three bags are coming again.
Interesting, yeah. So what's next, Dhanishta? What about Dhanishta?
Dhanishta, flute, music, again, Dhanishta is connected with certain, maybe again, because it's a Bhishma, so certain vow fulfillment, I will say.
Mm-hmm.
If you made a certain vow fulfillment, can be there. Dhanishta, some taste in music, or and don't be too critical. Sometimes I feel Dhanishta is very peculiar about certain taste, certain interest, so.
Bags. Dhanishta, I would say music. Dhanishta, I would also say listening to Vishnu Sahasranams. That's also Shravana Remedy. Sahasranams are Shravana Remedy. Also, like all the Sahasranams, our Kali Sahasranam, Planet Sahasranam, Planet Deity Sahasranam is Shravana Remedy. Even the Dhanishta, I would say music. Also, I would say working in groups. Dhanishta, I would also say not to become like Bhishma. Look at what mistakes Bhishma did in Bhagavad, in the Mahabharata. He was sticking by a vow, but then he didn't fulfill it. I mean, you know, he didn't even listen to Krishna. But definitely I would say then they feel lonely because of that also. They feel that they need to, Mars is getting exalted here. But then at the same time, not to become like Bhishma.
Yeah, the lesson to learn is, okay, you make a vow, but make sure that you fulfill that vow not with the cost of dharma.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly that.
What is right, what is wrong. Don't be too much get involved in your vow or day-to-day activity so that you lose the sense of righteousness.
Yeah, that's true. And dharma is instantaneous. You know, you don't... anything like that. What is happening right now is dharma. It should be dharmic. Interesting. Okay. And then Satyabhisha. What about Satyabhisha, Aditya?
Satyabhisha, healing, caring. 100 doctors, correct? So healing, caring, that can be. And so secret activities. That's also I've seen with Satyabhisha.
Yeah.
But definitely healing and caring is one of the theme. Some doctor visits, bark flower remedies and all those. So...
So you would also say like
secret thing is there because like there was a person who had, you know, Venus in Satyabhisha. He told me that what was the problem, then and I'm like, wait, let me guess. And then he ended up telling me that actually, long time back, my wife, she had a boyfriend earlier before marriage. Now, after my marriage, I came to know that, they are still talking and they are still, kind of making plans to meet sometimes and all. And then I'm like, when did you come to know about this? I said, just recently. So that secrecy thing is there, and Venus is the spouse. So that those things can come.
Because Varuna was the night Indra, basically.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of secrets, hidden secrets and all.
Interesting. Yeah, Varuna, Vasatabhisha, I tell them, definitely go to the ocean, take a dip in the ocean, simple thing. Go to the, other thing with Satabhisha, I say is attend conferences or attend attend fairs or places where large people gather. 100 people are gathered, go there. Do yoga class of doing yoga alone. That's a Satabhisha thing I would say, Or do some class and meditation class where 100 people are gathered instead of doing it alone. That's a Satabhisha thing I would say. Satabhisha also, one last thing is to serve water to people. Keep water for crows, keep water because it's Satabhisha healing, right? Or Varuna. So giving water to people or keep water for the birds to come and drink. It's a Satabhisha thing, I would say. What about Puravadra Pada? I think you mentioned stool before. What about Pada Aditya?
Puravadra, I will say, look beyond the normal. What is day-to-day life is going on. But then I think Puravadra natives need to look beyond what is routine. Because it's like a pedestal. What do you use the stool for? You climb on it to see something beyond it, correct? Something beyond. Yeah. So that's what I will say. You climb on something. So taking up activities which may be challenging, of course, climbing the stool and all is difficult, but then that will help you to look beyond. So look beyond your normal things. That's what one of the main theme of Purvabhadra Pada.
Yeah.
And of course, Ajay, Rudra Nakshatras, Homam, Rudra Homam, chantings, hearing Rudra Mantras. Yeah. Fire ritual again, because I think it's connected with some fire thing too, Purvabhadra Pada.
Fire also.
And Purvabhadra Pada people, I have seen, they should be cautious of, rumors sometimes.
Oh, really?
Okay. Rumors have this, oh my God, this is going to happen, and it's like that Rudra blazing crazy fire energy. Because I remember, because I'm from Assam in India, so recently, some months back, there was an incident where, there were two people. This was in a state called Karbi Anglong in Assam, in a district, I mean. So there in that place, what used to happen, there were many people who used to come and kidnap the babies, okay? And they are known as Hupadharas. Hupadhara means one who kidnaps, child kidnapper. So there one day there was a rumor that, there are two people have been spotted, that maybe they are like this. But these two guys were from very nice families, very good families. They were from Guwahati only. Very well educated also. But God knows what happened. They felt that, no, these people are child kidnappers. And they took them and they lynched and they murdered and killed them. And they took the law in their hands. And if I'm right, that day moon was in Purvabhadra Pada. Because in Uttar Bhadrapada, so moon has to be in Pura Bhadrapada that day. It's like that madness which comes, sometimes. He's the one, throw him out.
They have to calm down a lot, Pura Bhadrapada for sure. Because these are people who are to will take one philosophy and they'll take it to the extreme. Sri Yogi and Arjuna, they have to learn to calm down.
Now you talk Pura Bhadrapada, I see a stool coming now.
So definitely stool. Watch out for ladders. I think in Puravadra Pada, one big thing is that these people will be carrying furniture. They have to be careful when they become old and they're carrying furniture. And then their backs break, It's a simple thing. So Saturn and furniture and all that. So one thing they need to watch out for that. Other thing with Puravadra Pada is to do yoga for sure. Sometimes if they do yoga, they can get angry also. They need to calm down and do some more practices so that they can ground. Go to temples, walk, do some bhajans, and then do the yoga thing. It'll actually help them calm down also. With Purabhadrapada again, lion, so Narasimha avatar.
That's what I was going to say, you know, that madness.
Yeah, Narasimha avatar is definitely Purabhadrapada. It will help lion, right? So that's one thing I would say. Whatever Uttarabhadrapada.
The pillar also, they say.
And Purva Bhadrapada, I have seen regarding anger and all these are more there in that, you know, in the first three padas in Aquarius, and the one which is Pisces, it is like bit more of that understanding is there in people that okay, have happened and I can't do, but still they get angry, but they may not act sometimes. But if it is in Aquarius, the first three padas, oh my god, very difficult.
It's like dragon, I've seen dragon connections there. People are going to dragons, identify the dragon. So dragon is like training and stuff. Both also. Purvatrapada is air and Uttara is like water dragon. Like ocean dragon, Uttara. But yeah, dragon, if they identify a dragon and go dragon stories or Naga stories or, you know, Shiva stories, stuff like that. Uttara, right? So that's one thing I've seen. Puro, I'll say one more thing is that extreme, right? So two faces. It's fine to have two phases, use it in a positive way. You know, don't go complete extreme. That also. Other thing with, that's what I would say. What about Uttarabhadrapada?
Uttarabhadra, deep sea connection with wealth. And of course, prayers to Goddess Lakshmi can also be done on Uttarabhadrapada because we discussed. And I think what else? Of course, again, two faces, again, what else I can say? That's what
even occult black magic, right? Uttarabhadrapada, Purabhadrapada. So watch out for that. Don't do black magic upon others. Then I would say, like, Uttarabhadrapada, I would say one tree is great. There are many neem products that can be great, which Aditya mentioned. Second thing is that Narada Rishi actually gave something to Ahir Budni, something there. Narada wrote some book, right? I think you can meditate on that.
Pancharatra or something like that.
Yeah, something like that. I think Narada's version is there. Some book is there, like Bhagavatam or, you know, some book
Pancharatra is the way how you worship the deity, not do puja. Is it that or maybe some other book?
Narada actually instructed something to Ayurvedic.
Oh, okay.
Maybe
it's different.
Is there like that. Yeah, that is something really interesting. I heard about that. One thing is, what I've seen is like definitely taking care of your feet. It's a very simple thing, you know, like put it in salt water and, you know, things like that. Do all those kind of feet based remedies. Uttarabhadrapada also, like, go, what do I say, look in the basement. That is one more thing I would say. It's not always, you know, a basement and stuff like that because it's deep also. Yeah. Okay, finally, Revati. What about Revati?
Devati is caring, nurturing, you know, protection to animals because Devati is connected with that. Ferryman, that also has. So, nurturing, taking care of your teeth. Pushan has problems with teeth. So, I think having good teeth, paying attention to teeth, cleaning regularly can help activate Uttarashara, can help activate Revati in your child.
I would say definitely one place I recommend is Pushan, Pashupatinath temple in Kathmandu. I recommend that. Purabhadrapada, I actually recommend Jyotirlingas, all the Jyotirlingas if you can go through. That's helpful for them. They can calm down their energy by going to all the crazy Jyotirlingas out there, you know. Kedarnath and stuff, you have to trek 8 kilometers, 10 kilometers to get to the top. So by that time, you will calm down a lot. You know? And then I've seen Revati, I would say even like, music is great, you know. Shipping ships is helpful for them because of ferryman. Revati, I also seen like helping people travel or some kind of traveling or, you know,
traveling. Boatman, traveling can be there.
For Revati, I have seen, you know, unless they have a mentor, because that Pushan is that one who takes the sheep, right? It's like the last nakshatra where you finally obtain moksha by, you know, by blessings of the guru. So finding a guru and, you know, having that connection is very important. With
Revati. That's a great point. I agree. Yeah. Yeah, I think that's the quickest for all the nakshatras.
Wow.
That itself took 1 hour, I guess.
Yeah, it took 1 hour.
Yeah,
I think,
it's all almost 50 minutes. That was 20 and this is 30.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. Anything else you would like to share?
Anything else would you like to share?
I think, yeah, we have shared many things, I think.
Yeah, we planned for 1 hour and it ended up so long. Very nice, interesting. Thank you very much. And I forgot to say in the beginning, you both do consultations, am I right?
We go through Cosmic
Insights app, yes.
Yeah, that is the one question, two question. I do the consultations there,
Okay, okay. And Dr. Pai is also doing consultations now, or he's also busy in
Through Cosmic Insights, He's going through Cosmic Insights, you can order consultations from Dr. Pai also.
Okay. Nice. Yeah. Amazing. These three, four videos will stay in YouTube for eternity, and whoever wants to activate nakshatras, they will come back and back.
Yeah, I'll just say use it. You know, remember it's the first thing which I told. It's karma. So be aware about that.
Yes.
And do the quick fix thing. Do be aware that it's your karma, and there might be a reason for that also. It's like read them all the mythological stories and stuff. The mysterious reason behind all the problems which God has. Lord himself had to face. So there might be some kind of mystery behind all the problems or karma which you are also facing. Also, so just be aware about that as you are using the remedies also. That's a simple thing I would say. Yeah. And then definitely continue the nakshatra deities. I think that's a simple thing. Can mantras, devotion, all that. And that's also the other thing I would say. We haven't said that straightforward thing. Nakshatra mantras also help in understanding that and control that energy.
Not said about sounds also. There are many, many parts.
Oh yeah, you can go many. Nakshatra, you can make 100 videos on each of things, But yeah. But yeah, thanks Babuji. I think you gave us an opportunity to share. Maybe some of our karmas will be worked out by doing this.
I would have loved it if Dr. Pai would also be here, but maybe with some other time with him.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much once again for coming. And amazing it was, 3-4 sessions we recorded, and we will see each other very soon next time. Okay. Thank you very much. Namaste.